Welcome back to part two of our interview with Michael Ratner, president of the Center for Constitutional Rights, on the significance and implications of the Supreme Court decision which found the Military Commissions Act of 2006 unconstitutional. Thank you for joining us again, Michael.
Thank you for having me, Paul.
Michael, before we get into the politics of this piece, first let's talk about what happens next, the implications for the military, the consequences for the prisoners in Guantanamo. Let me read you what Justice Scalia says about what he thinks is going to happen. Most tragically, this decision sets our military commanders the impossible task of proving to a civilian court, under whatever standards this court devises in the future, that evidence supports the confinement of each and every prisoner. And again, he goes on to say, the nation will live to regret what the court has done today. Michael, how will this affect military process? How do you pick up somebody from the battlefield and then try to prove in a civilian court what they did or didn't do?
You know, Scalia's opinion here is really made out of whole cloth. First of all, most of these people were not picked up on a battlefield. They were picked up in civilian clothes based on bribery in Afghanistan, Pakistan, Africa, everywhere in the world. And what has to be proven by the government and what should be proven is that these individuals engaged in hostile acts against the United States and are therefore dangerous to the United States before you can hold them for any period of time. That's a standard of evidence that is used all the time in civilian courts and should be able to be proved. Unfortunately, what the military has done in these cases is it's coerced and tortured confessions out of people, and it considers that sufficient evidence to hold people.
This isn't the first time Americans have fought an insurgency with people who are not in uniform when they fight. What was the rationale in the first place for this?
There was no necessity. When we have fought insurgencies before, if you want to call what we have here an insurgency, they actually had an Army field manual process for dealing with people where you went through a hearing, it was decided immediately after you were picked up. This wasn't really about that. What this was really about is setting up an offshore camp where they would feel free to interrogate and, yes, sadly, torture people, something that's completely unauthorized by any military law, any civilian law, or the Geneva Conventions or anything else. But in the past, we certainly have complied with law. This time, we decided not to, and that's why we're in so much trouble here.
So talk about the politics of this now. Why now a decision from the Supreme Court? And what, if any, are the implications in terms of McCain-Obama on this issue?
And it's the third time we've been to the Supreme Court. Twice the Supreme Court, and they referred to it in this third opinion, told the government, told the Bush administration, and told the Congress, give these people habeas rights. Twice the Bush administration and Republican Congresses didn't listen and overrode the Supreme Court. And now the Supreme Court, at least one part of the politics, is they're angry that what they thought was a clear decision was overridden. And they're angry over the fact that the place of the judiciary to protect individual rights in this country was undercut and undermined. And so I think part of this decision is based on really a protection of separation of powers in this country and a protection of individual rights and an understanding that this country, going back to the Magna Carta in 1215 in England, that there has always been a right to challenge your detention when the executive or the king or whomever picks you up and throws you in jail.
John McCain has said he wants to close Guantanamo. On the other hand, he was one of the architects of this piece of legislation. It seems a bit contradictory. Well, where is McCain on this issue?
John McCain is a mess on this issue as he is on other issues. You know, Bush said he wanted to close Guantanamo also, but we see how far that has gone. On this issue, the fastest way to close Guantanamo is going to be adhering to this decision, because we're going to get very rapid hearings, rapid at least respect, you know, in a way 3 to 6 months or something, that will probably wind up with most of the people from Guantanamo being found not enemy combatants, found innocent, and being forced to be released. The fastest way, the only way to close Guantanamo is to actually get this into court. The military will drag this forever. So McCain, who not only authored the very law that was held unconstitutional here, now doesn't like the result. And he really doesn't know what he's talking about except to say, I just want to keep these people in there forever.
Now, did not vote for this piece of legislation, but at the time he said one of the reasons he didn't vote for it was because it was messy and might get overturned. Has he been consistently against this, or has he been ambiguous?
No, I think Obama has been more or less consistent against Guantanamo and against having these kind of rump hearings without habeas corpus. He's been quite consistent on habeas corpus. I actually worked in the Congress for a while trying to get habeas corpus through. His office was very accommodating. The statement he made immediately after the decision was very positive, lauded the habeas corpus rights. And so I think he's strongly with habeas corpus and the court decision on this matter.